You know what, it's one of the coolest things I've been involved with. They're so into it. Hilsey, yeah.
Listen, when Joey John says to you, mate, come outside me, come out, he called me around because Tony, our winger, is really fast, and he went, right, Hilsey, get out there, I'm going to you, you go off this guy's shoulder, get out there to Tony. And, I mean, when Joey says something on the field, you do it. You absolutely do it. Getting a little emotional now. You come from Warrington, you formed this team in February. Everyone's got disabilities. Warrington's a real working class town, and none of these guys thought they would ever play rugby league at all, if again. And now they've won a cup on ANZ Stadium, and I'm just so happy for them.
Well, we're very happy that Adam Hills joins us live now. Adam, thank you very much for your time. Thank you for all you do for rugby league. You've just come back from London.
Yes, so I got back 2 weeks ago, four weeks ago, and my wife and kids were already here, so I had to self-isolate in my daughter's bedroom for 2 weeks. I had to use the kids' bathroom. It was off limits to them, and my wife and I were socially, like, distancing from each other, so it kind of felt like we'd had an argument, but I wasn't quite sure what it was about.
I think we can all relate.
Before you came back, Adam, you actually were rubbing shoulders with Prince Charles. Now, we all know that there was problems within that family.
I mean, if you're going to rub shoulders with one of them, he's the guy to go with.
Tell us about that experience.
It was a fundraiser for the Australian bushfire relief, and I was asked to host it. And Prince Charles was there on the night, and it was kind of at the point where we knew there was something going on in London, but no one was told to lock down or anything. So I met him, and I kind of went to shake his hand and then pulled back, and he said, yes, I don't think we should we? And I said, no, I don't think so. And then he said, it's going to get worse, isn't it? And I thought, if I know before you, something serious is going on.
Look how that turned out for him. Adam, the 2021 PDRL World Cup, who will you play for, England or Australia?
Wow. I mean, if selected comes after that sentence, but... I mean, if given it, the weird thing is, so I'm wearing a top right now. It's the green and gold, but it was made by the Warrington Wolves. It was a charity top to raise money for the Australian bushfires. And I kind of think it represents where my heart is because, I mean, Warrington's my team that I play for. But I think if there was a World Cup, it's a tough call, but I think I'd have to go with Australia.
Hey, Adam, there's a bit of a mixed opinion at the moment about the NRL's push to start rugby league again. Where do you sit on this?
I mean, I think if it can be done safely, absolutely. I think that's all it comes down to. If it's being done safely and responsibly, then why not? I mean, you know, every performer at the moment would love to get out there and do what we do, and we can't. If there was a way we could do it safely, we definitely would. So I think safety and health are the priority. But if that can be guaranteed, then why not?
Adam, is it true that your wife, Ali, said that you playing rugby league at 49 years of age wasn't necessarily a midlife crisis, but it was better than you buying a Porsche having an affair?
Absolutely, and I'm not sure. Good. In the last 2 years of playing rugby league, I've fractured an ankle, I've done my ligaments, and I've been concussed, and I'm not sure if that is the same amount of injuries I would get if I had had an affair.
Now, I'm assuming the fractured ankle was your left ankle.
I could have fractured the right, but a bit of duct tape and some super glue would have fixed that one.
Hey, Adam, just quickly, speaking of ankles, before we let you go, how are you keeping fit? I've seen that you've been doing something that a strength coach gave you, but it's a little bit taxing.
It is. So, yeah, you can see it on your screen. So that was, we got a WhatsApp message from our coach at the Wolves, the disability team. And this is what I love about, you know, rugby league, but also sports specifically, because it's not just about physical health, it's about mental health. And the first training session that we missed, our coach sent round, he said, right, who's your favourite player, your least favourite player, and the team you support apart from the one you play for? And we answered and we didn't know why. And then the next thing, he sent us that alphabet with all of the exercises, and we had to spell out each of the answers that we had given, which was hard work because the team I support that I don't play for are the South Sydney Rabbitohs, and there's a lot of letters in that one. But then The following week, it went so well, they went, right, when you know what the game is, tell us your favourite and least favourite soccer team, and we'll put them into a mystery barrel, and we'll see what you get. And I ended up getting Borussia Mönchengladbach. That nearly killed me.
Oh, bless. That was a stitch-up, absolutely. Adam Hill, thank you so very much for your time. We really appreciate it, and hopefully we'll see you back out in the park very shortly.
Absolutely.
Cheers. Thanks, guys.
Thank you very much. And you're on fire today.
Well, he's got a documentary out too called Take His Legs. Yeah. And it's like, he's such a big part of the physical disability rugby league, worth having a look at. And he, like, when he's over in Great Britain, he basically stays down in London. He goes up and down to Warrington to train. Like, that's from one end of the country to the other almost.
How did you know what his wife said?
Who's having the affair? Your wife's having a midlife crisis.
No, I'm playing rugby league.
I actually met Prince Charles. Prince Charles told me. So
okay, it's as good a source as any. Okay, thank you, Adam. Did you want to write a reply?
Not only do you know what my wife said, but you happen to know what nights I'm out of the house.
On that classy note, we'll leave it there, Adam. Thank you very much.